number 555.
Joyful, joyful, we adore thee, God of glory, Lord above. Hearts unfold, heart flows before thee, opening to the sun above. Melt the clouds of sin and sadness, drive the dark cloud out away. Hear of immortal gladness, fill us with the light of day. All thy works with joy surround thee, earth and heaven reflect thy rays. Stars and angels sing around thee, center of unbroken praise. Field and forest, vale and mountain, flowery meadow, flashing sea, chanting bird and flowing fountain, call us to rejoice in thee.
We come together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. We come before God, mindful of salvation won for us by Christ, mindful too of the times we have sinned, as we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the Son of God and the Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who for the relief of the poor and the formation of the clergy, endowed the priest St. Vincent de Paul with apostolic virtues, grant, we pray, that afire with that same spirit, we may love what he loved and put into practice what he taught. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Consider your own calling, brothers and sisters. Not many of you were wise by human standards. Not many were powerful. Not many were of noble birth. Rather, God chose the foolish of the world to shame the wise, and God chose the weak of the world to shame the strong. And God chose the lowly and despised of the world, those who count for nothing, to reduce to nothing those who are something, so that no human being might boast before God. It is due to him that you are in Christ Jesus, who became for us wisdom from God, as well as righteousness, sanctification, and redemption, so that as it is written, whoever boasts should boast in the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed the man who fears the Lord.
Blessed the man who fears the Lord.
Blessed the man who fears the Lord, who greatly delights in his commands. His posterity shall be mighty upon the earth. The upright generation shall be blessed.
Blessed the man who fears the Lord.
Wealth and riches shall be in his house. His generosity shall endure forever. Light shines through the darkness for the upright. He is justice and merciful and just.
Blessed the man who fears the Lord.
Well for the man who is gracious and lends who conducts his affairs with justice. He shall never be moved. The just one shall be in everlasting remembrance.
Blessed the man who fears the Lord.
An evil report he shall not hear, fear. His heart is firm, trusting in the Lord. His heart is steadfast, he shall not fear, till he looks down upon his foes.
Blessed the man who fears the Lord.
Lavishly he gives to the poor. His generosity shall endure forever. His horn shall be exalted in glory.
Blessed the man who fears the Lord.
I think it's safe to say that not many, if any, saints started out as a saint. They started out very normal. They started out perhaps as ignorant individuals, as unbelievers, as betrayers. Just look at the apostles. They started out reluctantly. They started out going down a different path of comfort, if you will. They had no clue, no idea, no plan that, oh, geez, I'm going to start to be holy today because I'm going to be a saint. That just wasn't in the works. St. Vincent de Paul is no different. He would have been very content to have just lived his somewhat comfortable life and just enjoyed things. But rather, he was drawn into a path. He was drawn into a path that exposed him to, if you will, the poorest and the hungriest of individuals. And he was challenged to do something about it. He did so reluctantly. And as he did that, God continued to work through him, grow him, develop him, mold him, and fashion him. Just as we hear in that first reading of St. Paul, you know, God is using the weak to make them strong and really bring down the strong, if you will. God is using the ignorant to prove what true wisdom is. God uses the most opposite things, if you will, the most unusual things, the most unusual circumstances, produce what God produces, because there's space there. When we're so smart, when we're so strong, when we're so right, well, there's no room for God to do anything differently. So, trust what God is doing in you. I'm not suggesting you're stupid or weak or anything like that. What I am saying is that God's doing a good work in you, whether you realize it or not. Leave space for God to do that work, because perhaps each of you is on a road and a path to holiness, for that matter, to sainthood. Ever confident in God's care for us, we raise our voice in prayer.
For church leaders, may the Holy Spirit fortify them in their gospel mission, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders, may God form their hearts in goodwill toward those who are most in need, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those traveling the long road of grief, may they know Christ's presence and rest in the confidence that nothing can separate us from the love of God, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, especially Kelly Castle, John Chaturina, Bob Christian, Agnes Clark, Mary Dunkey, James Fairhead, Danny Firth, Floss Firth, Dacia Fertney, Robert Jaya, Terry Grimes, Julianne Jenkins, Deanne Lane, Mary Lombardo, Tom Morkowski, Lynn Mattingly, Chloe Pasco, Greg Rich, Carol Scaley, Paula Simmons, Tina Testa. For the victims and survivors of abuse in our church and beyond, for accountability, justice, and healing throughout our church, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here, may we be strengthened by the sacraments to share Christ with others, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the souls of the faithful departed, those who have recently died, Peggy Shunk, and for Edwin Sikowski, for whom this Mass is being offered, may they, through God's mercy, rest in his eternal glory, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions that remain deep in the silence of our hearts and minds, for those written in our prayer notes book, and for those we've been asked to pray for through our Renewal Recommitment Initiative, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we lift up in prayer the synod that will be gathering in Rome within a week, that they may be guided by the Holy Spirit, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, hear us as we pray that you send all things in the name of your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
as we have received the breath of you, fruit of the earth and work of the Indians, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Lord, accept the sacrifice at your hands, for praise and glory of his name, for our good and the law of this holy church.
O God, who enabled St. Vincent of Paul to imitate what he celebrated in the divine mysteries, grant that by the power of this sacrifice, we too may be transformed into an oblation acceptable to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of St. Vincent of Paul, you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life. Teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
The mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Edward our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other the sign of peace.
Have mercy.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let them thank the Lord for his mercy, his wonders for the children of men. For he satisfies the thirsty soul, and the hungry he fills with good things. by this heavenly sacrament, O Lord, we implore that just as we are prompted by St. Vincent's example to imitate your Son in his preaching of the gospel to the poor, so too we may be sustained by his prayers. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord, please glorify the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing number 555, verse 3. Thou art giving and forgiving, ever blessing, ever blessed.
Wellspring of the
joy of living, ocean depth of happy rest. Thou our Father, Christ our brother, all who live in love are thine. Teach us how.